Approximately 70% of the Earth's surface is covered with it. And more than 95% of it is in the oceans. It fills lakes, streams, ponds, and aquifers. It forms ice caps and glaciers. Sometimes it is invisible. It evaporates or exists inside life forms, like us. It quenches thirst, cleanses, and sustains life. But how long will the supply last? I'm a geochemist, studying the sustainability of arguably our greatest resource, both the quantity and quality of water. My research is in two areas I consider home, Chihuahua, Mexico, and Southwest Missouri. In Mexico, I have collaborated with colleagues to collect water samples in the Rio Conchos because it is rumored to contain arsenic. This contaminated water could then seep into their well system. Since people from Chihuahua rely solely on groundwater for drinking and farming, they are deeply concerned because there is a lack of communication about the availability of water. They fear not having enough. So when they draw from wells, many take more than is sustainable. They're making their worst fears come true. The water table is dropping. In an area known for its abundance of outdoor activities, I work with students to examine our streams. We search for traces of lead, zinc, and cadmium, which can harm aquatic habitats and contaminate the groundwater. In this otherwise healthy-looking environment, a former active mining area continues to have effects on our outdoor resources. We work to collect, prepare, and analyze sediment samples to determine the chemistry and history of contamination in this area. Together, we're trying to make sure that there is safe water in your glass. There are clean waterways to maintain a lively ecosystem, and that farmers can responsibly irrigate the crops. My work in this area gives me an opportunity to share sustainable practices for water, because without water, where would we be?